So today I'm going to answer a question that was submitted by Wendy. Do you have any advice on how to clean the resin from the inside of your smoker? Well, yes, I do. And today we're going to test it out on 5 different smokers, different levels of filth inside these things. This one had a mouse living up in the cone. That was a surprise to me. And this is the creosote that builds up on the inside, usually in the upper part of your smoker. And it can actually slow down the smoke going through the cone. And this is so that you can work on your beehives. We definitely don't want it to get really hot. So what's the problem? Up here in the top, not only will it slow the smoke, but that stuff can catch fire and actually give your bees a really hot smoke, which they're not going to like. Some of these have removable combustion chambers, so we're going to check them all. I thought we might as well do 5 at once. These are all the before pictures, so after we do this treatment, we're going to see what they look like at the end. This one probably is the oldest and most abused. It has never been cleaned, to be honest. So I thought, you know, why not demonstrate this today? This is a short video, and you're going to find out in the video description down below what I actually used to clean out these smokers. So we're going to show you the process, 5 smokers, different levels of cleanliness, and we're going to do them all. This shows the burn chambers up. Now the ones, by the way, that have these inserts tend to burn hotter, and the hotter it burns down below, the less creosote it's going to collect. So there are some design variances here, but of course they all had the same creosote at the top. We're putting pine shavings in the bottom. And I want to boost the heat a little bit, because when you're using this stuff, the hotter your smoker is, the better. So I'm going to get these coals out of my Vermont Castings wood-burning stove. This is the Defiant model, for those of you who want to know. And I'm putting some of that in each of these. And I can tell you, after having done this, I recommend that you put a lot more fuel in these, because the hotter they're burning when you do it, the better it's going to be. Why not do this outside? Why are you doing it in the wood stove? Well, outside, look what's going on. It is snowing, of course. Tonight it's going to go down to the single digits, so I can't do it outside. I thought, why not just put these things right in the wood-burning stove, let it vent through the chimney, and then we're going to see how that goes. So it would be great if we could put them all in at once, but I found that I can only put 2 or 3 in. In fact, 2 is preferred. Most of you will only have 1 or 2 smokers anyway. You're not going to do 5 at once. And of course, I take the lazy man's way, and I'm lighting this with my fire igniter, and that's just Coleman fuel that you would use for lanterns when you're camping. And again, if I were doing it over again, I would put a lot more chunks of wood inside the burn baskets here and I'd get it nice and hot before I put in the creosote cleanser. So this is smoking pretty good. Let them get going. Don't be in a rush. They have to be over like 260 degrees. In order for the whole chamber to heat up, in order for this creosote remover to work. So just like when you're out in your bee yard, let them sit there and smoke for a while, let them heat up, all the surfaces on the inside get nice and hot, hotter the better. And again, you want to vent this to the outside, and I'm using my chimney to do that. So there, they're burning, they've been doing it for a little while. Let's add some of this creosote cleaner into each burn chamber. Open it up. I'm putting 1/3 of a scoop in there. 1 full scoop is supposed to treat your entire firebox. So it is designed for cleaning out combustion areas that are enclosed, like a wood-burning stove. Now this one, I added some more fuel just to kick it off and make a comparison, and that was a smart move because that one got the cleanest. The 2 on the right just had the fuel that I showed in the beginning. They heated up. They did okay. You're going to see at the very end of this exactly how that came out. But the more heat, the better on these. This is the final product. Look at those spark arresters at the top. They're nice and clean. The cone areas where it was really encrusted, nice and clean. This second one here, it still has some thick stuff down in the bottom. Not perfect, but again, I would put more fuel in these to burn that out. But all of them had nice clean tops. So that's it, where the cone is. That's what we really wanted to get rid of there. Not only that, they open and close easier. Bonus. So what did I use? Here it is. This is Rutland Creosote Remover, and it comes in a spray bottle too, which I thought might be cool to try that out. I'll just tell you right now, I don't like the spray. Didn't work too well. I do like this stuff, Creosote Remover, for fireplaces and stoves. Again, this is the formula. It's designed for closed-in combustion, and this is the 32-ounce size. It works great. Plus, when you put your smokers in your fireplace or in your wood-burning stove to do this procedure, you're also cleaning your wood-burning stove. So that's a bonus. And again, remember, you could remove these screws. You can put all of them in your fire chamber at the same time. You can do the same process, of course, in the summertime outside somewhere where you're nice and safe and sound. So I hope that this answered Wendy's question. This is what I'll do from now on. Until she asked that question, I hadn't really cleaned my smokers. Thanks for watching. Have a fantastic weekend. If you're just now discovering that it's Valentine's Day, it's too late. You're already in trouble.